Good morning students, how are you? I hope you are all doing good. As most of you know me, I am Sudipta Kundu, your chemistry teacher, and we have already moved from offline to online mode. So from today onwards, I will be taking your chemistry classes of whole class 9. Now, as we have already started a chapter that is matter in our surrounding, and other subject teachers have already completed the few of the topics, so now I'm not going to start from the beginning, rather I'm going to start from the topic that we have left, that up to which it is completed. Now, as we have discussed that what are the characteristics, and also we have discussed about the different properties of the three different states of matter. Now today we are going to discuss about the change of states of matter. What is change of states of matter? That is, we know the three states of matter, solid, liquid, gas, and each three states of matter can be interconvertible. That is, solid can be converted to liquid and liquid can be converted to gas, and also the solid can be directly converted to gas and vice versa, right? Now today we are going to discuss, as we know what are the steps involved, but today we are going to discuss in the details that how this change of these particles of the matter are able to overcome the mechanism behind it. Now tell me, suppose I have given you the ice at 30 degree and I told you to convert into water vapor 100 degree. What you will do? You will provide a heat to the system and you will see the conversion, that is, ice is converting into water and water is converting into water vapor, and this is all it. That how this heat is actually helping the ice to convert from water, and then it is converting the water vapor. The heat that I am providing to this ice 30 degree, they will absorb this heat. The heat will be absorbed by this ice as a kinetic energy. And kinetic energy means, kinetic means what? Motion. So as the kinetic energy will increase, the motion of this particle, we know that what will happen, that as the energy will increase, the motion of the particles will increase. Now you will be having a doubt that solid being are closely packed, have a strong intermolecular force of attraction, then how they will move? They won't move, but rather they will start vibrating. They will start vibrating in their mean position. And you will see that here you can see the system, and each particle will absorb this heat as a kinetic energy, and they will start vibrating. As they will start vibrating, the intermolecular force of attraction between the particle will weaken. Will weaken means asaste durbal hobe. And asaste durbal hobe, and along with that, what you will see? You will see that there is a change in temperature. That is, ice is converting from 30 degree to 0 degree. Now at this point, as soon as the ice is reaching the 0 degree, you will see that ice is converting itself from ice to water. That means from solid to liquid, but there is no change in temperature. The temperature is not changing, but ice is converting into the water. Now what is actually happening to the heat? I am providing the heat continuously, but still there is no change in temperature. Now this heat is acting as a hidden. Now this heat is actually, again, they are absorbed by the particles, but now these particles, what they will do? They will overcome the force of attraction. Now before conversion from ice to water, the ice was actually taking the heat as a kinetic energy, and it was actually weakening the force of attraction. Now what they will do? They want to overcome the force of attraction. Overcome means, now we know that solid has a strong force of attraction, whereas liquid has a weak force of attraction, right? Weak means moderate force of attraction. Now, in order to convert it from solid to liquid, they have to overcome the force of attraction. And in order to overcome the force of attraction, what they will do? They will take the heat as a latent heat, and they will absorb this heat as a potential energy, and this potential energy will help to overcome the force of attraction. And with the help of this, they are able to convert from ice to water. Ice to water, that means from solid to liquid, and it will continue to take the heat as a latent heat until and unless all the particles of ice is still converted into water. মানে যতক্ষণ না আইসের পার্টিকেল পুরোপুরি ওয়াটারে কনভার্ট হচ্ছে ততক্ষণ কিন্তু এই হিটটা ওরা নিতেই থাকবে অ্যাজ আ ল্যাটেন্ট হিট অ্যান্ড দেয়ার উইল বি নো চেঞ্জিং টেম্পারেচার নাও as soon as all the particles of ice has converted into water particles, that means has converted into liquid states, now after from moving this point from water, they will, what will happen? Now this temperature will started increasing and they will reach to from water 0 degree to 100 degree. That means again the same process is involved, that is these water particles of water will absorb the heat as a kinetic energy, and as the kinetic energy is increasing, the particles of the motion of the particles will also increase, and as a result again since we know that liquid has a moderate force of attraction, so as the particles are continuously in motion, so what will happen, this will weaken the molecular force of attraction between the particles and they will reach a point to up to which water at a 100 degree, that means the point will reach, you will see that the temperature is increasing. Now again when the water is reaching at the 100 degree, again you will see that water is converting into water vapor, but still there is no change in temperature. Again the temperature is not changing, but you are providing the heat continuously. Now what is actually happening? Again the same thing, this heat is acting as a hidden heat, that is latent heat, and this heat is absorbed by the particle to overcome the molecular force of attraction of the liquid, and as a result, as a point, and you will see that as they will overcome the force of attraction, the liquid particles will start converting into gaseous particles, and in this way the conversion of the three states of matter occurs. Now what is actually happening in this ice, from ice to water, ice 0 degree to water 0 degree, this point is actually called what? Melting point. This point is actually a melting point. What is melting point? Melting point is a point, is a minimum temperature where the solid is start converting into a liquid at the atmospheric pressure. And this melting point will actually help to determine the strength of the force of attraction. Right? Similarly, what is actually happening from water to water vapor? At the sun, that means where there is no change in temperature, what point it is called? The point where the water is converting into water vapor, that means liquid to gas, that point is called boiling point at atmosphere. So what is boiling point? Boiling point is nothing but a point, a minimum temperature where the liquid is converted into a gas at the atmospheric pressure. This is what boiling point. So you have understood. Now let's discuss. Now you have seen that how this heat is actually helping the conversion. Conversion, that means heat is first absorbed in the form of kinetic energy, which will increase the vibration of the molecule, and it will help to weaken the intermolecular force of attraction, and it will reach the point ice at a 0 degree. As soon as it will reach, you will see there is no change in temperature, but ice is converting into water, and that point is called melting point. And what is it actually happening? The heat that you are providing, this heat is actually helping the particles to overcome the force of attraction of the ice and converting them into water. As soon as কতক্ষণ করবে যতক্ষণ না সবকটা solid particle is converting into liquid particles. As soon as it is converting from ice to water, all of the particles are converted, again the temperature will increase, again the heat that they will start absorbing the heat in the form of kinetic energy, and this kinetic energy will increase the vibration or the motion of the particles, and also increase the temperature, and will reach the point 100 degree. As it is reaching the 100 degree Celsius, again they are absorbing, again the heat, this heat is not helping in the changing temperature, rather it is taking absorbed in the form of potential energy, and again it is actually helping the particles to overcome the force of attraction and convert it into from liquid to gas. Now let's discuss that. So we have seen that the heat is absorbed into two ways. Now let's see how. So in conversion, we have seen already, we have discussed that heat that we are providing to convert from ice to water vapor are utilized in a two ways. Utilized means absorbed in a two ways. That is one is actually helping in the changing in temperature, the other one is actually helping in the changing state. And this changing temperature is actually absorbed in the form of kinetic energy. They are absorbing the heat as a kinetic energy, and they are absorbing the other one, they are absorbing the heat as a potential energy which is actually helping the overcoming the force of attraction. Now how you will calculate this heat? The amount of heat absorbed in this where the temperature is changing is called, it can be calculated Q equals to mc delta T, and the amount of heat absorbed is which is helping in the changing state Q equals to ml, where L, you know what is L? L is nothing but a latent heat. Latent heat means, that means, now suppose ice at 0 degree is converting into water. In this, latent heat is required, and this latent heat is required, and this latent heat is actually overcoming, is absorbed in a form of a potential energy and converting, overcoming the force of attraction, right? This is what, and this latent heat is called, where the solid is converting into a liquid, this latent heat is called latent heat of fusion. Similarly, water at 100 degree is converting into water vapor. Again, the latent heat is required. This latent heat is called latent heat of vaporization. That means, what is latent heat of vaporization? Latent heat of vaporization is the heat that is required, the amount of heat that is required to convert 1 kg of liquid to gas. That is latent heat of vaporization. That the heat that will help in the conversion of liquid to gas, and the heat that is helping, that is required to convert from 1 kg solid to liquid, that heat is, that latent heat is called latent heat of fusion. So let's summarize it, what is actually happening. So suppose ice from minus 30 degree you want to convert into water vapor, right? 110 degree. Now first, what will happen? The ice will convert into ice at 0 degree, minus 30 degree to 0 degree. What kind of heat is required? What kind of heat is required? That is, this heat will absorb as a kinetic energy, and the heat that will be absorbed is equals to Q equals to mc delta T. Again, in this way, the ice is converting into, now the ice will convert into water vapor at 0 degree. Now the heat that will absorb in the form of potential energy, and the amount of heat that they will absorb equals to L, where L equals to latent heat of fusion, right? Again, the water is converted to water at 0, at 100 degree. Here again the heat is absorbed as kinetic energy, and the amount of heat absorbed equals to mc delta D. Again, the water will now convert into gaseous state, that is vapor, at 100 degree until another. And in this way, the heat is absorbed as a latent heat in the form of potential energy, and the amount of heat that will absorb Q equals to ml, where L equals to latent heat of vaporization. And then the water vapor, again after further applying the heat, the water vapor will change the temperature from 100 degree to 0 degree. And in this way, the conversion is actually happening. Now, if you want to represent this in the form of graph, then how will you represent? Suppose you want to show this conversion in the form of graph. So what you will do? Take a temperature versus time graph. Now you want to represent them in the graph in the form of temperatures versus time graph. What will happen? Suppose you have started minus 130 degree. From 130 degree to temperature, this is 0 degree, this is 100 degree, and 110 degree. Now what will happen? Temperature will increase. As the time will go, temperature will increase. At 0 degree, there will be no change in temperature. So this. Again, as soon as the water is converted into ice is converted into water, at 0 degree, again the temperature will increase and it will reach the water at 100 degree. And it will again, the point it will come, there is no change in temperature and the water is converted into water vapor. Okay, 100 degree. Now, as soon as all the water is converted into water vapor, it will get converted to, it will now further will rise in temperature to water vapor. So here you see, this in this way you will able, in this way that we can represent them in the form of graph. Now what is happening? The amount here, the kinetic energy increasing, potential energy increasing, again kinetic energy is increasing, potential energy is increasing, and here also kinetic energy is increasing. Here the temperature is increasing, here the temperature is increasing, and here the temperature is increasing. Here Q is equals to, here Q equals to MC delta T, here Q equals to ML, latent heat of fusion, here Q is equals to MC delta T, and here equals to Q equals to latent MLV, where V equals to latent heat of vaporization, again here Q equals to MC delta T. So this is how you represent the graph. So we will discuss up to this now. In the next class we are going to discuss about the how changing pressure helps in the conversion of the states of matter. Till then, thank you and have a nice day.